All right, everybody, I just wanted to talk to you a little bit about the client hello as a part of the TLS handshake. Now, in previous videos, we've showed you how TCP first will establish a handshake with a server. And then after that handshake gets established, well, then TLS can begin to do its thing. Now, during that handshake, there's a whole lot going on. So I'm going to do my best to break it down simply for you. And we're going to start in this video by taking a look at the client hello. But before we start digging into the weeds, let's get just a bit of a brief description of what's really happening during that handshake. So here I just went out to Cloudflare, and here I think they just have a really nice graphic for us and also a very good description of what happens during a TLS handshake. Here we can see a client and server and they're communicating, but basically it tells us that during that TLS handshake, the two communicating sides exchange messages to acknowledge each other, verify each other, establish the encryption algorithms they will use, and then agree on session keys. Okay, so the very first step of that is the client hello, and that's what we're gonna look at today. But enough talking about definitions, let's go ahead and get into the packets and have some fun. Now you can follow along with me by clicking in the link down in the description down below to download this PCAP and follow along, or you can go ahead and capture your own. Just fire up Wireshark, hit a server out there on the internet, stop Wireshark, and take a look at the client hello that you're sending from your machine. Okay, back into the packets. So here we can see we have our syn ACK. There's our TCP part of the conversation. That's TCP kicking off. Then right after that, we have this client hello. So let's go ahead and take a closer look at what's happening in here. If I come down here, so after TCP, so there's my connection establishment at the transport layer. Then we throw security on top of that. So right away, I can see that this is a handshake. So if the content type is ever handshake, then that's gonna be the total handshake part of that TLS conversation. Now on another one of my profiles, I'm actually gonna flip over. Now on another one of my profiles, I've actually colored those. If I come back to TCP plane, you can actually see that the handshake messages, I just made more of an aqua color. I did that by setting the content type to handshake of 22. So you can do the same if you want to. You can come up here, you can just grab this, go up to the top, and then you can take this and copy it and put it into a coloring rule. Okay, so up to you. Let me go ahead and remove that. Okay, so one of the first things that the client hello wants to do is negotiate the version of TLS. Now there's a lot of different versions of TLS. Going back to SSL, we had SSL 3.0 in somewhat recent history, TLS 1.0, 1.1, 1.2, and then very recently we have TLS 1.3 becoming a standard. So both the client and the server have to use the same version in order to communicate. You can't have a client using 1.1 and the server using 1.3. So in that client hello, the client will inform the server of the versions that it supports. So let's actually see how that works in the packets. Okay, so if we just take a look within this client hello. All right, so we're gonna pass TCP, come down to transport layer security. As we can see, this first field is called a TLS record. So a record is how data is exchanged within TLS endpoints. So this is the very beginning of the TLS handshake. So we can see here that this is the content type handshake. Well, next we have version. Now, this is where it really depends on the version that the client is using. If it's using an older version of TLS, this version field is basically telling the server, this is the lowest version of TLS that I can support. The highest version of TLS that it can support will be down here in the handshake protocol, down here in the version field. So if this was a TLS 1.2 client that was trying to establish that version communication, it would be, hey, I can go as low as 0.1, but I can also support 1.2. And likely if the server does support 1.2 as well, that's gonna be the version that's selected by the server. But in the case of TLS 1.3, it's different, and let's see how. And as we can see here in this packet, in this client hello, we have TLS version 1.3. But you might be thinking, okay, Chris, why does it say 1.3 when we have, first of all, TLS 1.0 and TLS 1.2 here? Well, what's different about TLS 1.3 is that we have something new, something unique to version 1.3, and that is a supported versions extension way down here at the bottom of the data. Okay, so hopefully you can see that okay. I'm just gonna make sure. I'm just gonna resize this just a little bit so you can see it okay. All right, so just coming down here. So this is unique to TLS version 1.3. So the very fact that we have supported versions down here means that this client can support TLS 1.3. In fact, if we expand that, we can see that the client is saying, hey server, I can support TLS 1.2, I can do TLS 1.3. So coming up here, why do we see these two versions? Well, first one, this one is just our record version, and this is our Handshake version that we're using to negotiate. So in TLS version 1.3, this value here is always going to be TLS 1.0. And we're going to take a brief look at the standard to see why. So in here, I'm just on the 8446 standard, the RFC, and this specifies TLS 1.3. If we come down here to page 79, we can see that in this document, we're talking about TLS 1.3, which uses this version of 0304. That's the version for 1.3. But it specifies, in order to maximize backward compatibility, a record containing an initial client hello should have version 0301 reflecting TLS 1.0, and a record containing a second client hello or a server hello must have version 0303. So what does this all mean? Well, basically, the standard is specifying just leave this version at TLS 1.0 for backward compatibility. Some servers, if they didn't see 1.0 coming in, it would break them. So let's just keep everybody happy and use version TLS 1.0. So what's the takeaway? If you're using TLS 1.3, you don't really use this field. Now, coming down here, version TLS 1.2. Why would we advertise 1.2 if we're really TLS 1.3? Well, this is where middle boxes, maybe they aren't yet up to date on version 1.3. So it's possible you still see TLS 1.2 here, and that's just to bypass those boxes in the middle so they don't end up dropping it because it's a version they don't yet support or understand. The real version is going to be negotiated because we have a supported versions field down here, and that's where we advertise that to the server. So let's flip over to the server hello. Let's come down to the server hello, and the server comes back, and notice what it's doing. It says, okay, version TLS 1.2, 1.2, great, wonderful, kicks that back, but the supported version is TLS 1.3. So this server does support version 1.3, so we go ahead and use that going forward, and that's our version for this communication. Now, there's a lot more that could be said here about versions and that negotiation process. In fact, comment below if that's something that you'd like me to demonstrate for you. Maybe we can find some PCAPs of some broken TLS conversations or handshakes that were due to incorrect version compatibility. All right, but let's keep going. All right, next in our client hello, let's take a look at the Cipher Suites. So if we come down here, I'm in the client hello, Cipher Suites. Here, this client is offering 16 suites to the server. Now, what is a Cipher Suite? Basically, it's a collection of algorithms. It's like a recipe. Hey, server, I want to use sugar, flour, eggs, honey, and in that order. And the server says, hey, do I have that same recipe? Okay, let's go ahead and go with that recipe. But what's actually contained in that recipe, for real? So if we come down here and expand this, here we can see that we have these different Cipher Suites that are supported by the client. And again, this is basically different algorithms for encryption and also for data integrity. So we tell the server, I want to use this language, if you will, to derive bulk transfer keys and also to validate that the data is what it should be once it's received on the other side. There's a lot to unpack with this piece, but what I'd like you to take away from this is all of these are possible recipes that the client supports. Okay, and they're not necessarily in order of priority or the most secure up on top. It's just a list that it supplies to the server. Now the server on the other side, let's see which ones it offers. Now if I come down here, I can see in the server hello, just gonna look at the Cipher Suite. You notice the Cipher Suite coming back from the server is just one. So the server is going to be selecting the suite that will be used, and that will define the encryption between the two endpoints and also the data integrity. More on that in another video. In fact, go ahead and comment below if you'd like to see more about that. All right, coming back to the client hello. So after that piece, if we come down here, okay, we got the Cipher Suites. There's a couple other things that we can focus on in the client hello. One that often grabs my attention is coming down here to server name. Here I'm identifying which server I would like to talk to. Well, for now with TLS 1.3, this is still unencrypted. We can still see this. So the nice thing is we can still filter on that. So if I go up to the top, for example, I can just say, I'll just say TCP contains Wireshark. So this filter is going to show me any TCP packets that have the clear text string of Wireshark in them. So this is still, for now, open. We can still see it with a TLS handshake. It's one of the few things left with TLS 1.3 that we can still read in clear text. However, yes, there's plans to make that go away, but we'll go ahead and handle that another day. Now, also, another thing that's going to catch my attention in the client hello, if I come down here, just go down a little bit further, I can see application layered protocol negotiation, ALPN. And this is where the client says, hey server, this is the application that I want to use. HTTP2 or HTTP1.1, what do you got on your side? So this is where the server will come back and actually select the application that will be in use. In many cases, again, modern browser using TLS 1.3. Most of the time today, we're going to be using HTTP2. Now, there's a handful of other extensions that we see here, kind of beyond what we're going to be talking about with this video. But again, this is helping us to establish that encrypted connection between the client and server. Absolutely something I peek at, supported versions, TLS 1.3, 1.2. And then we can see some other finishing things down there in the client hello. So this is how that client will initiate that client hello to the server. So for now, we'll go ahead and leave it at that. In a future video, we'll take a look at the server hello and dig a bit deeper into how TLS works.